Good morning.
Welcome to Lviv. It's 7 a.m. We arrived by train from Kiev at 6:20, so we got into the city. It was really easy by tram. You just kind of have to ask which one goes to the city center. Ours was number 31.
And it took not very long.
No, maybe. Like 7 minutes, 10 yeah. minutes. And now we're literally walking through the beautiful city center. I said it reminds me of Poland. Eric seems to think it's just all Eastern European cities.
There. Not all, but a few of
a
them
lot.
Look. They're like, looking similar, like
Prague
squares.
Is similar.
Prague, yeah, could be it.
But this is it. It's quite nice.
It's a little foggy right now when the city's waking up. So.
And behind me is the city opera, which looks really gorgeous. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we're gonna try to go. Apparently our Airbnb has some sort of storage, so we're gonna try to drop off our bags there and then take a nice long breakfast. But alternatively, just like in Kiev, there is also lockers in the train station, so you can always see your luggage there.
And the bus took just four hryvnias.
Four hryvnias per person. We only had 100, so we went in to pay, and the guy was very upset with me. He said he's not a bank and he doesn't have enough change.
So have some small bills on you.
Alright, so we're at this place called Gas Lamp, and the idea is basically, it's kind of like themed with these like old school kerosene lamps, so you have like a whole variety of them on the shelf, and you have a lot of floors, so right now we're all the way up on the patio. It's a pretty massive place. And we just got our food, and it looks friggin' amazing. So this is Herrick's rib.
It's pork ribs and cherry sauce.
Which looks really, really good. And then there is some potato skins and a pickled platter. So it all looks really good. It's all rather cheap.
You ready?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. So we're just going to take a look at, it's not a monument or anything, but basically apparently the story goes that someone just threw out some toys and it seemed to have grown and grown, and then it became what it is now that you see over here right now. We're just going to check it out. Maybe because it's raining right now, it seems a little sad. Mm-hmm. Kind of like a graveyard for toys of some sort. So we just went inside this cafe called Maso Cafe, and it's supposed to be based on the concept of this famous guy called Leopold Maso, and from a psychology point of view, he was kind of like the father that brought about the concept of people that like things like S&M. And this place here, there's a statue of him outside. But then in here, there's certain things like you can see on the menu, it's like work pleasure, orgasms, and so on and so forth. And you'll see people that are working here, they have whips, and they will dish out whips to you. So we already got smacked in our ass when we're coming in.
Very casual spanking.
Casual spanking. But when we came in, we saw some guy with a shirt on, and he was getting lashes. Five lashes or something, and his back was all red. Yeah, even when you're sitting casually, and I had to lay back down with my open back, and she came and lashed me a few times, so interesting place. We'll see how the cocktails are, but if you come, prepare to get a little bit of a beating. All in good fun though, so it's okay.
Oh shit.
So we are inside a restaurant now, it's called
Kriivka.
Okay.
And what this is basically a Ukrainian version of a speakeasy.
Yep.
this was like an underground hidden places, bars where I think soldiers or partisans back in the day would come into. It's pretty dark inside, and in order to get in you need to say a password, and the password is Slava Ukraini, which means glory to Ukraine. Again, there's no sign by the door, you kind of have to know where you're going.
But this menu is interesting in itself. It talks a little bit about the place, shows some history, and apparently you can try some shooting skills. The interesting thing is at the end, about some general things that you can and cannot do here. One that says Russian swearing is not permitted, but Ukrainian swearing is tolerated.
So we got some potato pancakes. We got half a liter of some kind of alcoholic cocktail drink. And this is banush, which is actually corn with mushrooms, pork crackling, and cheese.
We're shooting Putin today. We just shot Yanukovych, and now we're shooting Putin.
I think in the nose or under the eye?
This is the exit to the restaurant, apparently.
Yeah, these are flasks for drinking.
Not sure if this dude's your Mother's Day, but there's so many flowers going by. Let's walk through here. All nice and beautiful. Thank you. Mine's way less exciting than yours. Ooh, it smells nice.
Mm-hmm.
So what are you supposed to do with it? Just smell it?
I don't know. Can I smell it? This is really cool.
It's our last day in Lviv, and we're gonna start up with some breakfast of champions with some deep fried chicken on waffle, which looks amazing. And we have some kind of milk cheese, almond,
we don't really know,
something kind of mixture on toast, looks great. And this is in a place called Diana's, which is right on the main square. Beautiful view, patio next to Diana Fountain. And you'll see dancing out there when it's nice weather at night at times. One of the famous restaurants called House of Legends. Every day this streetcar actually moves at a specific time, and this dragon up here I think is every day at 9 o'clock will breathe some fire, and there's a bit of a mini show, and it's supposed to be a nice place to go check it out, a bit of a themed restaurant. So on top of the very roof of House of Legends, you'll see this car here, and you'll get a nice view of over the city of Lviv. Of course, you can also eat and drink here. Everyone seems to be having this cherry liqueur, I guess. Yeah, that's a little spill that Nasha did, but just cherry liqueur or anything special?
Well, I think just cherry liqueur. It's not nearly as like heavy and sweet as when you get it as a shot. It's really good.
Okay. So we were in the park and we decided to kill some time by playing some cards that we have. Apparently a set of Russian cards that, or they, I don't know, they're in German, so I don't remember where we got them from. but they're...
They look like Russian.
They look like Russian, but then they're written in German.
Yeah, but that's Russian design.
But, so we started counting to make sure we have all our cards that was available. And what do I see? I see, you know, commons, sevens, you see eights, tens. And then I start seeing, Masha start showing, it's not Jack, Queen, and Kings. Instead, what do you see here?
So for Jack, it's Valet.
Valet, which looks like a B.
So it's equivalent to Jack.
Uh-huh.
And then for Queens, we have a Dama.
Dama for D. Okay,
so it's
kind of
like, it makes sense, I think.
Okay.
And then key for kings,
yeah.
And then for aces, it still says an A, but they're called
okay.
twos.
So my thing was, okay, we're totally missing a lot of cards. There's aces, but then there's no twos, threes, fours, five, six. And the Masha tells me in Russian, it starts from sixes onwards to six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Well, not Jack, Queen, King, Ace, but those other ones we
yeah,
just showed you. So
we're only missing sixes, really.
That's an introduction to Russian cards, because that was a big revelation for me.
Yeah.